Well, at Sunshine Coast, we're finding consistently that one of the problems with the drug use and why people tell us they're taking it is because there's not much going on in their life. Or the way we would phrase it, of course, is that they don't feel they're living a personally meaningful life. And we had a client, and I think we were treatment center number four with him. And his pattern of relapse, I mean, he had an aftercare program. I mean, every time he went to treatment center, he left with his very detailed schedule aftercare program. You know, go do X number of community support meetings, you know, go see the doctor, go to family counseling, you know, all of this things that we would typically find in a traditional treatment plan. But every 6 months, he would relapse. And he was baffled by it, and his family were completely baffled by it because, you know, once he cleaned up, things were going good, right? Yeah, he didn't get into trouble at work. His wife was just thrilled about it. The kids loved it. And then he made this comment. He said, "Yeah, when I clean up, I always go for 6 months, and everybody is happy. Like everybody, like, I mean, people aren't on my case anymore. I mean, I'm not spending money. You know, we're not, there's no financial problems. You know, work is just going along." He said, "Everybody's happy except me. I've never been so bored in my entire life." And that story is very common when we talk to many of the clients at Sunshine Coast. So everything's going well except for the client. So he's, in fact, he's just putting in these motions up until he reaches a point for him, it was 6 months, where he just couldn't take it anymore, and he had to do something. Because basically, what he was saying is he didn't feel alive, he didn't feel vital, he didn't feel energized. He was just going through his daily routine, but for him as a human being, it just wasn't good enough. And he knew from lots of experience that intoxication would at least give him that feeling, right? So this is very interesting, right? And this is at Sunshine Coast, what we consistently discover, that if a person after recovery does not personally feel, you know, doesn't really wake up in the morning with excitement, feels that maybe you know, the job isn't all that exciting or interesting, maybe they're just going there for a paycheck, that this will seems to this will lead to relapse. So the key then to an aftercare program really is to help the person figure out, like, what do they want out of life? Like, what does it mean to them to feel alive? And to keep this focus on that. Just as the idea that if a person leaves recovery and their one focus is to keep away from the drug, you know, that's not a good way of feeling alive. And that focus generally ends in relapse. Much better to go out and find what is it that I would like to do in my life? What will it make me feel alive? Yeah. And this personal idea, this is, I think, what Ryan and DC were getting at, was this idea of self-determination and what am I going to choose for my life? And what do I want to do with it? And to keep promoting this. And William White, another researcher in the field, he did a study of seven people in recovery, some very famous people. And he concluded at the end of that study that perhaps the focus shouldn't be so much on abstinence as to get a life, because he made this comment that perhaps abstinence is the byproduct of this process of beginning to live meaningfully. And certainly at Sunshine Coast, this is what we routinely hear from our alumni. If our alumni tell us they're doing well and we ask them what's going on, what they've done is start living their life. If it was important for them to be a father, then they put a lot of energy into that. If it was important for them to be a good member of the community, they would start volunteering and doing things like that. If it was important for them to work at a meaningful job, they either found another job or somehow took the job they had and made it much more interesting to them. One fellow I remember told us he worked in a bank and he got the bank involved in sponsoring minor league hockey because he loved hockey. So he made the job that he had, which before was kind of dull and boring, according to him, and now it became much more interesting because he now was a spokesperson for the bank and their and this all this work the bank was doing for minor hockey. So that seems to be the best recovery plan, encouraging the person to go on and find this something that's personally meaningful. And along the way, just don't let them drift, you know, keep in contact with them, right? See, how are things going, right? What have you been doing to improve the quality of your life? Things like that. And it's so important because in all our research with our alumni, one of the things that we have found is if the quality of life is deteriorating in the sense that they don't feel alive, this is almost a guarantee of relapse. However, if their quality of life is improving, and again, defined by are they living the life that they're choosing to live, that is self-determining and personally meaningful, then, and they can even go through all sorts of struggles, financial, health, and otherwise, but they seem to have this, to keep away from the drugs. So it's quite interesting in that sense.